What? Me? Direct? Oh, no. That's really.
You'll be home soon.
I want to do this play because I'm fascinated. I've been fascinated with the dream world in relation to the real world.
You as an actor.
Me as an actor, me as a human. And I always wonder when I see someone in a feel like I was with them for real. It's like if I see my grandparent in a dream. You know, have you ever like woken up from a dream and you're like and your heart is pumping like it actually happened. And you're sweating and you feel like it's real. And I just think there's something that about the human, I don't know if it's a human condition or emotion, or just life in general, but there's something about the dream world and the way we as people access it and the way we react to it.
True.
That I don't, I'm like, is that real? Are you all there?
I think so, yes. Are you?
Oh yes, I'm all here.
Charlie and Mary are such diverse characters, and this is, as we've described before, such a marathon play. So being able to apply these tools in such a way that actually matters, you know, instead of just taking one thing and applying it to a character that's in one scene in a show, and not that that's bad, but this gives me the chance to go through an entire arc of someone and find where I find my niche as an actor, and I think that's super helpful for me right now in my process, and I'm really grateful that I have a character that lets me explore that, and this play is so beautiful. I'm so happy to be a part of this.
You can see from us, you think they were out there. If the U-boats were out there, they could see us pretty good. If they were near here looking for us, they'd have some pretty easy shooting.
That's why we don't smoke on deck. What's her name? Hmm? The girl's name?
Mary Sergeant.
Mary Sergeant?
Mary Chalmers. I don't know any Mary Sergeant.
Charlie and Mary.
Mary and Charlie. Doesn't really ring, does it?
It's going away.
They always do.
Is everything all right with your mother?
Yes. Just a little tea emergency.
Oh, a tea emergency.
She wanted to know who you were. If you were that dirty farm boy with the horse who saw me home the other night.
What did she tell her?
Does he look like a dirty farm boy?
What did she say to that?
And I would really like for them to, we're going to have sound effects, but I would also like them to like almost hear it based off of the way we speak it and like have this sense of like when we talk about the mud and talk to smell it and to, you know, almost like feel what it would feel like.
You finally saw a German soldier. Charlie, please, we do not have to talk.
Tell me!
Coming back through no man's land, 10 yards from your barbed wire, you saw him when you were coming back into sleep.
Hey, do you see that? Hey, right there. Hey, see? Sergeant. Do you see him?
Who is it?
A scout or a... Or a sniper?
One of ours?
No. I don't know. No. What should we do?
We drop him. If he crosses that line, take him.
I see. Go back. Come on, go back. Please. Go back.
The sniper, the ghost, the German, the person. He kept coming closer from puddle to puddle. And you wished he'd go back. You wished he would, but he just kept disappearing and appearing closer like he was trying to catch up to your front. Until he crossed the line, and you held your breath. And then flowers touched the back of your shoulder. And your rifle made the quick sound of one axe stroking wood.
There was a splash, too. A splash when his body hit the water. This is the worst thing I ever did.
As I look back, fly back and spy back over my first directing project, I smile and giggle, remembering how wild and alive my inner artist was with the four brothers of Michael Chekhov's principles being alive through the entire project. I was calm, confident, and secure with my vision, using the synth analysis and directing guidelines as laid out in the National Michael Chekhov Association playbook. The project overall had a continuing theme to have fun. I was constantly amused and energized with a sense of ease as I prepared rehearsals. Roadblocks that came up were battled with beauty, and I adopted Lisa Dalton's newfound phrase, how to turn crummy to yummy. I reminded myself to cultivate my higher ego with encouraging, supporting, and assuring my team at every opportunity. This entire project has helped me to develop psychological flexibility, vulnerability, and a newfound artistic lens I never knew existed. Thank you from the bottom of my heart to everyone who helped me bring Mary's wedding alive.
Toto, please stay with me.
I can't stay. I have to go now. And it's time for you to wake up.
I can't.
Yes, you can.
Please don't go. Kiss me, please.
I love you.
I love you so much.
You are the best thing. The very best thing. I'll see you someday.
I hope so. I do hope so. There's a thunderstorm coming.
I don't mind getting a little wet.
Would I do it again?